Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today. Now I would like to discuss about anterior vaginal wall retractor. So this is the anterior vaginal wall retractor. If you see, it is mainly identified by presence of long straight rod, and on either sides it has a broadened ends, and in the broadened end, in the center, if you see, there is a fenestrational hole at the center, and if you see the broadened ends which are there, they are serrated like this. Because this is how you remember, you identify anterior wall, vaginal wall retractor. How? There is, this is by presence of a long straight rod, and on either sides you will have broadened ends, and there is a fenestration or hole present at the center of this broadened end, and this broadened end has, broadened ends have some serrations. So this is the way how you identify vaginal, anterior vaginal wall retractor. There is one more instrument in the gynecology and obstetrics which looks similar to anterior vaginal wall retractor, but it is a little different. So if you see this, even this instrument, it is straight and it has broadened ends, and it has serration, it has a fenestration, one fenestration or hole on ends. But the main difference between this instrument and this instrument is presence of the serrations. In anterior vaginal wall retractor you will see these serrations, whereas in uterine curette you don't see any serrations. That is the main difference. Presence of serration signifies it is anterior vaginal wall retractor. Absence of serration, that will show us that it is uterine curette. Now, what are the uses of this anterior vaginal wall retractor? This is used to retract the sagging anterior vaginal wall while using sim speculum to retract the posterior vaginal wall. So we retract the posterior vaginal wall with the help of sim speculum, and we can retract the anterior vaginal wall with this anterior vaginal wall retractor. So this is about anterior vaginal wall retractor. Thank you for watching my lecture.